listeners and welcome. This is our favorite program, Voice of the Priest Against Corruption, a program of the Priest Peace and Justice Initiative, PPJ, mobilizing Christians against corruption in Nigeria, focusing on the Pentecostal Assembly. With strong support from the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, my name is Oche Ocheme, and I am your host on this wonderful program. The Pentecostal movement, with its promises of prosperity, has drawn a large followership, offering a potential critical mass of adherents in the fight against corruption. Today, we shall be looking at Pentecostalism, the potential, the problem, and the prospect, as well as corruption and how it relates to corruption. When I return, I will be introducing my guest. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back. My guest today is a conflict resolution expert. He's a board member of several standing organizations in the society, liaison officer of Priest Peace and Justice Initiative, PPJ. Make welcome my friend, my pastor, and my guest, Pastor Joseph Igbozo. Pastor, you're welcome, sir.
Thank you, Pastor Uche, for having me on this platform.
All right, Pastor, straight to the point. My first question is, sir, has the Pentecostal movement, with its promise of prosperity, aided the spread of corruption in the church in any way?
I will start by reading a scripture from the Christian Standard Bible, James chapter 4, verse 17. I quote, he said, "So it is sin to know the good and yet not to do it." With this question you have posed before me, invariably, let me do a little analysis of what and how Pentecostalism began as a movement where some Christians faithful gathered to pray and do Bible sharing as part of their Christian religion practice. However, over the decades, this prayer through Bible sharing was metamorphosed into religious denomination, and within a very short period spread like wildfire into different parts of the world. Nigeria is not an exception to this global development in the Christendom. However, some spiritual teachings of the Pentecostal churches have continued to be matter of concern. Thus, many begin to view it differently, of exploring the impact of these religious ways of life on Christian religion. Though some churches, primarily the teaching of prosperity and wealth, is opposed to the teaching of Christ, which emphasizes suffering and the cross on the basis of Christianity. So, just like as mentioned, it becomes an affair for Christians to begin to define what Pentecostalism is to them as an individual. Thank you.
Now to our second question of the day. Does the lifestyle of some Pentecostal leaders give negative impression about Christians' attitudes towards corruption?
The lifestyle of some Pentecostal leaders give negative impression about Christian attitude towards corruption? Yes. I subscribe to it because you find out that the flamboyant way people dress and leaders parade wealth and convert wealth in society attribute to a lot of people that they don't longer believe even in hard work, because the lifestyles of these leaders as mentors to entire generation has led a lot of people out of the will of God for their belief.
Thank you so much, Pastor Joe. My experience over the years hosting this program is one of the challenges people living in denial of the existence of corruption in the church. And several guests have emphasized the fact that one of the ways to challenge corruption or to address the challenge of corruption is to put system in place. are there things the Pentecostal Assembly can learn from the Orthodox churches that will help in their accountability process?
Yes, there are things that one can learn from the Pentecostal Assembly, in which the Orthodox churches, in terms of structure and how the institutions are being organized. Most of the Pentecostal assemblies don't have that institution or that structure. I beg to say that, you know, when this program started in earnest, and after the training that we have also had, you know, it becomes imperative that we can compare notes of how some of these assemblies, you know, conduct faith, and in terms of the structures and institutions, as it were. But from the little discoveries and from response, it is becoming obvious that most of these institutions are not properly organized or not well thought of, that it will help to build a better society, because structures is very important, institutions is very important. It serves as a model or as a guide to everyone that is involved in terms of being part of the Pentecostal Assembly.
If you're just joining us, this is Voice of the Priest Against Corruption, and my guest today is Pastor Joseph Igbozo, who is doing justice to the topic. Thank you so much, Pastor. Sir, how can the Pentecostal Church rid itself of the negative image which has been created over time?
Yes, there is a reason why a lot of people today, they are part of the Pentecostal Assembly, just because of the lifestyle of the people. But I may take it that it has negative image in the entire society, because if you look at my opening statement, I gave a comparison of the Pentecostal movement, and to the essence that it is not all about wet. Don't forget that nowadays, most of the youths or people who come to the assemblies have their own personal agenda against the scripture. So whatever they are being told from the pulpit becomes their way of thought of life, and becomes their lifestyle that they follow suit. And it will not be out of context to say that if the scriptures are grounded, and some of the people who parade themselves in this assembly are well trained, well tutored, well cultured, it can have a lot of areas of influence over society and how they parade themselves in the place of worship. My counsel on this will be, because if we don't crystallize this and look at a way of profiling solutions to it, it will be a huge challenge to the body of Christ. That, you know, there need to be a revival or intervention in the Pentecostal movement, so that people will be reoriented in terms of how they believe and the issues of lives. The revival can come in terms of prayers and in terms of training, because I have seen over times that most of even the people in course of this project that has been taught are being to have a renewal mind and thinking with regards to corruption and so many things. And the church needs to put strategy across board, so that first of all, there need to be a spiritual revival before they begin to have a rethink, and Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost will help us in this. Then also, the Word of God cannot be faulted. The Word of God becomes the sustainability that a lot of us we have in our hands to begin to challenge whatever that is wrong in our environment. If you look at the scripture in Genesis 6:5, that says, crystal clear, that in the course of creation and at a point in time, God himself began to look at creature and said to himself, can this be the people I created for myself? And let me quote verbally from the Christian Standard Bible, Genesis chapter 6, verse 5. And the Lord said, my spirit will not remain with mankind forever because they are corrupt. Their days will be 120 years. The Nephilim were on the earth both in those days and afterward, when the Son of God came to the daughters of mankind who were born children in them, they were powerful men, old and famous men. When the Lord saw that the human wickedness was widespread on the earth and they were inclinations of humankind was nothing but evil all the time, I decided to take it from verse 3 to 5 so that we shall have that understanding. Based on this, corruption can be dealt with, corruption can be nipped in the bud if the people of God have a renewal of mind. Also, my conclusion is that it will be a good thing with regards to what you are doing by adding a voice to the world in terms of how corruption can be worked against, and most of the things in the narratives has also helped people to grow. I appreciate you and thank you for having me. God bless.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that has been my guest for this week, Pastor Joseph Igbuzo. And as usual, it has been a very, very eye-opening and interesting episode. Till I come your way next week, my name remains Ochel Ocheme, saying shun corruption.
For more information, you can visit our website, www.priestassembly.org, or email us at info@priestassembly.org, or Twitter @priestassembly.org, Facebook, facebook.com/priestassembly, and of course, we're on Instagram @priestassembly.
Phone number 0905-159-0284. 0905-159-0284. God bless you.
Yeah. Why my people just suffer? Why we hope we get light? The rich be getting richer, the poor getting poorer. Tell me what's the reason? Corruption. 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 But I will never be corrupted. Corruption. Corruption. But I will never be corrupted.
I'm in the building, about to get this calling. Some of these ladies think we foolish, so I had to do this. I had to do this to let them know we know what they're doing. They promise to be changed when they know they cannot do it.